Finally, I've taken footage of me setting up a cart. Recently, I was able to go out of state and take a cart to an event. I didn't film working the cart as we were much too busy, but I did, I think, cover the cart setup for you. When I arrive at my location, I pull out my pans. This video will demonstrate a 3-pan direct heat setup. I will also run through the steam pan setup, and if you still have questions, feel free to give me a call or email, and I will be happy to help. Most carts operate on propane, so this video should apply to you no matter where you bought your cart. You will also find that most carts have a full-size steam table, and some, like the Big Dog cart, have almost a double-size steam table. But it makes no difference for the purpose of explaining how to set up your cart on location. You will find a method or an order that suits you. Don't let my methods deter you from finding your own way. So let's get going. You will see me put in 3 pans. These are 1/3 size pans, which means that a standard firebox or steam table is full size and you can put in a multiple combination of pans. Pan sizes are always based off fractions off the original full size pan. So you could have 1/2 size pan and 2 1/4 size pans to cover a full size pan area. There are many more combinations like 1/9, 1/6, 2/3. I'm using 3 1/3 size pans for this setup. I'm boiling my hot dogs and so I'm using direct heat, which means the pans are heated directly over the flame or heat source. Once the pans are in place, add water to each pan as shown. Note that even though my cart is equipped with a water system, I still brought water for my pans. This makes life easier and saves the water in your cart for hand washing or utensil cleaning. Our carts have deep pans and allow for more cooking space. Some carts will only hold shallow pans, and this will limit the amount of product you can make in a timely manner. Pan depth on most carts is only 4 inches. Our carts use 6-inch pans for direct heating. I then add beef bouillon cubes. This pre-saturates the water so that the fresh, clean water doesn't sap the flavor from your hot dogs. A can of beer and a garlic clove will also do the same trick. You will notice I make sure my valves are all off. Then I slowly open the valve at the tank. Now you can proceed with lighting each burner one at a time. Do this by slowly turning on one of the control knobs to a burner and lighting. I use electronic match or a long regular match. Do not turn your valve on too high because too much gas can escape and cause a small explosion. Turn it on just barely and light. Practice this without the pans in place to get an idea of what you're doing. Never stand directly over the burners to light unless you forgot to shave because too much gas can ignite at once and scorch the hairs right off your face. It's easier to light your burners prior to inserting pans, but you will find that you will turn off the flame from time to time so that you will need to know how to light the burners without removing these hot pans. Now start with one burner at a time, if you have multiple burners. Turn the knob slowly and light. Once you notice a flame, you can adjust to a lower setting. Too much heat and you will scorch your pans or turn your cart into a hot plate. If equipped, light the other burners. A little practice and you will have this down to a science and you will be able to know how much water and how many dogs for the size pans you use. On 1/3 size pans, I put about 4 inches of water and then once boiling, I add my frozen hot dogs, about 20 per pan. After 7 minutes, they should be ready to eat. Remember, I'm using pre-cooked hot dogs, which most health departments require, so all you're doing is heating them up. Too much time in the boiling water and you will have split, open, bloated hot dogs. So be mindful of the time boiling. Now, when you have finished boiling your hot dogs and turned off the flame, you can let the hot dogs sit in the water and await their fate. Once I use up 1 pan of hot dogs, I will start another boiling and do it all over again. I use aluminum foil sheets to wrap my dogs as I serve my customers. One hand has a glove on it, and then the other hand holds the tongs. I take my gloved hand to grab a bun and then with the tongs I open the pan lid, grab a hot dog and place inside the bun. I close the pan lid and add the toppings or I loosely wrap and hand to the customer and let them add the condiments themselves. Pretty easy, huh? You will get better and better and faster until it's second nature to you also. Now, let's discuss steaming. I don't have a video of my steam pan set up, but I think after this you will understand how it works. Steaming involves using steam to heat the hot dogs instead of boiling. It's easy to do, but requires a little different pan setup. One pan will hold water, called a spillage pan, and then inside this pan you can have solid pans sitting in the water or just above the water, or a perforated pan so that as the water in the spillage pan heats up, it produces steam that in turn seeps through the holes in the perforated pan, thereby steaming your food. Another easy steaming method is to use false bottoms. These come in sizes to fit about all pan sizes. In the bottom of a standard pan, you would have about 1 inch of water and then the false bottom, which is just a metal stand that sits in the pan just above the water level, and it's perforated to allow steam to come through. They call these false bottoms and wire pan grates. The difference between steaming and direct heating dogs is a matter of opinion. Many vendors boil and an equal number steam. You will eventually have your favorite method also. I hope this helps as you get started, and please be sure to check out our Facebook page for giveaways and keep up with my blog for tips and tricks, stories about other vendors, and more. I have also written a course in book form. It is for sale at most bookstores online and at our website. Best of all, it's less than $10, and we'll walk you step by step through the entire business and also give you some brilliant tips and tricks I've picked up along the way, like how to get free hot dogs and water. Thanks, and have a wonderful day.